Hello, and thank you for joining us for another AEGIS Solutions service repair video. Here we have an iPhone 4G, AT&T. This was my personal iPhone. I just received my iPhone 5, and basically I'm going to replace the LCD digitizer so that I can put this up for sale on eBay or Craigslist. Basically, there's two tiny cracks in adjacent corners of the screen. Right here where I'm rubbing my thumb, one here and one here. And basically, this is not really intended to be a repair video. It's just basically to show you what we do at AEGIS Solutions and the different type of services that we offer. I've kept this iPhone basically in an outer box ever since I had it. But one time I took it out my outer box, obviously I dropped it and I sustained those two cracks. Here we have a couple of tools, a few tools that we'll use to repair the iPhone 4. Basically just a pry tool, star head screwdriver, Phillips head screwdriver, flathead screwdriver, and then some additional plastic wedge pry tools. Now repairing the LCD screen digitizer for the phone, fairly straightforward if you know what you're doing. The process usually takes about 30 to 45 minutes. We usually tell our customers between 2 to 4 hours, just because we like to test the device fully when we receive it, and after we repair it, we like to test all the features as well, and again to allot for, you know, some issues that may arise. We'll test the home button, charge port, speakers, Wi-Fi, home, lock button, volume buttons, make sure everything works, and obviously make sure we can
make a phone call. We're going to start the repair.
This is the AT&T version, one of the earlier versions of the 4G, so it does not have the star head screws on the back. So the star head screwdriver I will not need. I'm not going to talk too much through this video. As you see, a lot of videos online, they have the magnetic mats so they can organize their screws. Basically, I just create a mental grid, and I will also just keep associated parts with associated screws. So back cover, two back screws right on top. First thing I do is I get rid of the battery. That's the battery tab. It just broke off. And you can see it never had any water damage. All my dots are still white. So very interesting that that broke off just now. So I'm just going to get under this screw. I'm using the metal pry tool. And I just want to get under the battery and just kind of lift it up. Okay. Here's the battery. And I'm going to move the battery screw to where the battery is. Now I like to remove all the cover plates. I remove the cover plate for the ribbon, and then we'll work our way down to the speaker charge port area. Charge port actually doesn't come out, but the speaker and the antenna does. Now, when you've repaired as many screens as we've repaired, you can kind of look at the screws and kind of tell where they go. And again, creating little zones will just help you out that much better. I am going to take out the vibrator. Leave those screws in or next to the vibrator. I didn't see that fall, but it did. And that's the other screw for the vibrator. Now you'll see a lot of videos where they're using the plastic pry tool. I use them sometimes. Metal one actually works a lot better for me. And no, I haven't had any issues with metal to metal contact. Okay, and antenna removed. And we'll come back up and we'll work our way back around from the top to the left and then down so that we can, I'll have to remember those two screws are for the speakers once I get them out. But for the 4G, the AT&T version, motherboard has to come out first because there's a little tab underneath the speaker that's basically sitting on top of, the motherboard is sitting on top of a tab right that's connected to the speaker. One thing I did forget to do, and it's okay, is we have to remove the SIM card. That actually helps to hold the motherboard down. Okay, SIM card out. I will go to a small pry tool just so I don't use my fingernail unlocking these little clips. Basically, you just lift up on them. And there's a little tiny screw underneath there.
Yes, it'll have a little
screw indentation in it, but that's okay. Now the motherboard is out, the speaker comes right out. I'll actually stick the speakers next to the screws. These screws, do not take them out. Just want to loosen them just a little bit. And the corner screws, you will have to take all the way out. Okay, what I like to do is just take a flathead screwdriver. A lot of times people will pry with a plastic pry tool. Right here where the camera was located, basically I just like to take a flathead screwdriver and kind of press. Basically it gives me a gap. Then I can take my metal pry tool, and then just slowly work and pry the screen. Now, you know, you heard a pop. Basically, I didn't break anything. It was just the adhesive letting go. A lot of times people like to heat up that adhesive. When you start to pry, you get some of the adhesive that stays on the metal facing and some of them that stays on the underside of the screen. When it's cold, basically, it just releases and you keep a nice clean adhesive on the metal frame. And what that does is basically allows you to just reuse it. With all the screws that are being used to hold the digitizer LCD combo on, the adhesive is just an added benefit of security. So you heard a little pop again, but again, that's the adhesive just releasing. And as I remove the digitizer, none of it is on the back. All of it's still in place, and I can just reuse it again. Okay, I'm gonna take this and set it aside. So now that I set the metal housing aside, I'm gonna focus my attention on the old digitizer. Now, if you notice, the old digitizer still has the mesh screen for the earpiece. Some of the new ones come with them already in place, but this one in particular does not have it. So I'm going to need to remove the metal screen from the old digitizer, and we're going to place it onto the new one. Flathead screwdriver, you can come from the front and just give it a little push. Again, it'll just pop right out, and when it's cold, you'll kind of keep the adhesive on that unit. So set that aside and we'll bring in the new fascia and we'll just place it right there. Now you can place it right on the screen. And just press it into place. Or I could have just took it off and actually placed it in the recess, which is here, of the metal piece. Okay, screen is on, didn't fall off. One other thing, the camera lens plastic housing basically holds the camera in place. We're gonna remove that.
The camera lens, little plastic faceplate housing in place.
I'm going to remove the back cover from the LCD. And then we're going to start reassembling. Okay, using the original adhesive, get everything fitted. Make sure that the washers are in the right positions for all the screws, and they are. And we're going to attack the four corners.
Okay. LCD is securely in place. Flat around all edges and sides. And held securely with 10 screws total. We're going to position the ribbon down in there. And we're going to go kind of in reverse order. I like to start with the motherboard, get that in place. And some of you may say, well, you took out the speaker last. Well, actually, the speaker, when put back in the correct way, you're able to get it underneath this little tab at the bottom. Help us temporarily hold it in place. I normally go ahead and slide the SIM card in. I'm gonna pick another securing attachment point just to hold the motherboard in place. But I don't tighten anything down all the way right now. Basically, I just wanna make sure it doesn't move and hold its alignment. And I can kind of go in reverse order. You know, I went from left to right. I can kind of go in reverse order. So, just to get the camera out of the way, I'll put the camera in. Snap it down, put all our ribbons down. In case you're wondering, I did test the LCD prior to me disassembling the LCD. Basically, as you pull these ribbons that I just placed down, which is the touch and the LCD ribbon, just pull them up, lay them back on the old screen, and then you get your new screen, and then you basically just place it overlapping like that. And then you're able to power back up the device. Prior to taking out the battery, just to make sure that the digitizer, the touch feature, and the LCD still works. Okay, all ribbons down and secure. I'm gonna move to my speaker. And before, I couldn't get the speaker out because in order to get it out, you need to lift from the top. But going in the opposite direction, you can actually place the top in first, and then with two fingers, press it down and forward and into place, just like that. That way the clips that basically grounds the antenna to the entire frame gets put in and seated correctly. I'll take one screw, which is not that one. It'll be the longer one. And we'll secure the left side. Excuse me, the right side. Go. Again, magnetic screws are the best. I'm going to secure the other side. That's pretty much it. For the bottom, we'll put the antenna, clip that back onto the board. Okay, antenna is down, and we'll go ahead and lay down the basically the speaker home button ribbon cable. Okay, continue to work backwards. That's our next spot. Speaker home button ribbon cable tie down plate. And again, I'm not tightening anything. And really, at this point, I actually could go ahead and tighten down some screws. I'm going to go ahead and attach the vibrator. You know, I really love this phone. I'm going to be a little bit sad to see it go, but testament to Apple products. Resale values are excellent. Basically, this was a 16 gig iPhone 4, and I should be able to sell it, upgrade to the 5, and even upgrade to the 32 gig, which I actually did. Before I go any further, just so that we test the screen on camera, I'm not going to put the ribbon cable plate on yet. I'm going to go ahead and jump right to the battery. I want to power on the device and actually see where we are. This little plate that's underneath the battery cover is the antenna pull down plate, and the little piece that sticks up basically grounds it to the back of the rear cover. Now, the rear cover seems to be all plastic, so I'm not sure where this small metal piece goes. Some have said that basically it's a way to determine whether you've entered your device or not, but I'm not too sure. Okay, battery's on, and we're just going to power on the device. Apple logo, brand new screen, and then we'll just basically test the touch feature and just make sure the swipe works. Then we'll be able to go ahead and just put on the back cover plate, close out the device, get it up all the way, so that we can go through all of the features. Lock button, volume, mute, home. Make sure it charges, make sure the audio works, and we'll stick a SIM in that actually works, and we'll test that as well. There's our screen, there's our touch feature. So there we have a successful replacement of the Digitizer LCD replacement for the iPhone 4G. Here we are. Got it all back together, putting in the final screw for the back cover. We're going to go ahead and leave this cover on. So we have the front end, the back cover on. Back cover doesn't look as good. We'll go ahead and fix that real quick. Still doesn't look as good, but I'm not sure how long this video is going to be.
but my SD card basically was a 2 gig card at HD, and I had to stop the video and basically remove the video from the card because I ran out of space. The card stated it gives 20 minutes of record time, so, and basically I only had to remove the card once, so which is a total of 40 minutes. So we did the entire repair. Most of it, I think we did captured it all on camera. And that would put us in the 30 to 45 minute range to do the screen replacement. So thank you again for watching. If you have any questions, just comment below. You can visit us online at www.aegis-solutions.net. And stay tuned for more videos. Thanks for watching.